year, 10% of the population, or about 20.9 million American adults, suffered from depression. Many of those treated it with the use of drugs. But today, naturopathic physician Dr. Theresa Ramsey is here to explore the natural ways to deal with depression. And obviously, with the holidays right around the corner, you know, we always hear that that seems to
very
increase.
Very exacerbated, yes.
But for a lot of folks, it's every single day, and sometimes you don't even know you're depressed.
Right.
What are some signs that you might be?
One of the first signs of depression is fatigue, lack of motivation, lack of joy, lack of desire. That's one sign, wanting to sleep all the time. And just not getting joy out of life, you know, just not feeling that elated feeling. And so when we talk about mood swings, it's about being up and down, up and down. And of course, we have the classic teenager who's up and down all the time,
right,
because their hormones are up, you know, changing. But there's a foundation underneath the hormones that I was going to talk about. And because we're all such visual learners, I made a visual for your viewers today. So no, this is not a baby's mobile with Christmas balls on it. Basically, what this is showing is that there's a foundation nutritionally of our health. And there's basically six nutrients that are really essential for balance. And if they're out of balance, which I'll show you in a minute, we start getting those ups and downs. For example, if we drink a lot of alcohol, one of the main nutrients that are depleted is B vitamins. And so if our B vitamins, for example, are depleted, here they are, it's going to show, look at how unbalanced the body is. So the body wants to be in balance. There's something called homeostasis. That means steady home. The body's always doing that because it will rob and pull nutrients from tissues to make the blood always look normal. That's why blood tests aren't always that essential. So if this is up and down all over, you know, that's the foundation is nutrition. We talk about nutrition
right
all of the time. So what are the nutrients going to do is cause imbalance in our neurotransmitters, which is our serotonin production, which is what antidepressants target. And also it's going to create an imbalance in our ability to handle our hormones. And that's why teenagers, you'll see them, boys and girls alike, go through the mood swings. And what we have to do is make sure they're nutritionally sound.
Okay.
There's a triad.
Teenagers usually are not nutritionally sound. They're eating junk a lot.
And so their mood swings are going to be worse.
Yeah.
And so there's a triad to make it really, really simple.
Okay.
There's three things that can help balance hormones across the board. And there, I have my triad right here. It's one is L-tyrosine, which is an amino acid. And 5-HTP. These are precursors to serotonin.
I've never seen these before.
You come in pill form, powder form, spray form. I just bring different ones to show. But these are two things that are precursors to making your own serotonin or feel-good hormone.
Huh. And it says it's a spray. So
these are sprays. You can just spray it in your mouth. It's just one other way you can take a nutrient besides pills. And then B6, folic acid, and B12. All three of those B vitamins are essential. They're great for premenstrual syndrome. And they're good. All these are good for treating acne in teenagers too. I mean, just those mood swings and all the imbalances that you see when we're not nutritionally sound. I mean, it's really important.
So these three things will offset when that's out of balance.
That's right. These three things are the major things here. Of course, the one that's not in your hand, I talk about all the time, is fish oil.
Yes.
And for women in particular, especially teenage women and even women of postmenopausal years, evening primrose oil is wonderful at just keeping that nice, smooth, even feeling throughout the holidays and always.
Do you digest that?
Yes, you can take evening primrose as a pill or you can take it as a liquid.
Okay.
But really, it's about where do all these nutrients come from? Vegetables and protein. So when we're eating all the high carbs, fast foods, it's going to deplete our nutrients. Plus, we have stress depleting our nutrients. Plus, we have bad choices like alcohol depleting our nutrients.
Now, what if you're not having mood swings, but you just want a little lift every day to feel better? These would be the three.
That's my triad that works 99% of the time.
So that's to keep you from having those highs and those lows.
That's right. L-tyrosine, L-tryptophan, and the B complex.
And don't you find that the highs and the lows happen a lot during the holidays?
More so, absolutely. You're going to want to conk out more because family's coming, or you're going to get elated because you're getting everything ready, and it's, you know, it takes a lot of energy too.
Yeah.
Plus, we're not sleeping as well.
Right.
And so, yes, we need to keep the balance in the body.
Wow.
So these three are you know, winners a lot of the time.
And
they're non-toxic.
Okay.
They're over the counter. And people can use them throughout the holidays and always.
And you just spray them, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen anything you just spray in your mouth.
Because some people don't like to take pills or can't swallow pills.
Right.
And again, it's just another way that you can take them. But you can buy these in pill form at the health food store.
And can most people take them? Anybody?
Mm-hmm.
They're safe.
They're not contraindicated if you're on antidepressants. They're not contraindicated if you're on the birth control pill. They're really wonderful nutrients that are natural to the body at all times, but deficient most of the time.
So we hit mostly on mood swings here, but we're going to talk about depression.
Depression is a very different kind of story, so we'll talk about that.
Interesting. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Ramsey. Mm-hmm. I like those three things. So if you want to contact Dr. Ramsey or you want information on what we just talked about, you can go to our website or dial our hotline. We'll come back a little bit later. We're going to hit depression because for some people, it's not an easy hole to crawl out of.
Right.
So we'll talk about
exactly.
But Gail is, Gail's on, but she came back. Thank you very much. Naturopathic physician Dr. Ramsey spoke earlier about natural remedies for mood swings, and now we're talking about depression because that's a biggie.
Yeah, it's a little heavier.
Oh, yeah. So it needs to be treated differently than just a mood swing sort of
definitely
thing.
Definitely does. Okay. It needs a lot more respect. Actually, they both need respect, but, you know, a lot of people are on antidepressants for depression, and in no way do I mean for this to replace that.
Okay.
Because sometimes it is genetic and you need that. But what is interesting is that there are, the way you diagnose depression is through a questionnaire, the DSM-4. This is standard of medicine. And if you answer so many yes out of the number, then you're diagnosed. Basically, it's very subjective. What I like to do is use a more objective way of testing. And so there's a lab called neuroscience. And basically, this is a way that you actually measure your neurotransmitters in your brain.
Oh, really? So this isn't a written test. It's something that's physical.
You collect it. Actually, it's a urine test.
Huh.
And what you do is you collect your urine in a little cup, and you transfer it to a little vial, bring it in, and we send it off to the lab.
Interesting.
And it has all your neurotransmitters in here. And then they actually make recommendations that are usually nutraceuticals. And, you know, the number one...
What's a nutraceutical?
Nutraceuticals means nutrients rather than drugs.
Okay.
But psychiatrists will use this lab to monitor drug therapy as well to make sure the person is on the right drug.
Okay.
Because it measures the whole cascade. Remember the balance of nutrients? There's also a balance of neurotransmitters that occurs.
Okay. And how much does age play into that when your hormones are... are kind of all out of whack.
Okay, when hormones change, so we see two big shifts. One is when we go through menarche or we get our period, and that's a big change in hormones. And then later on in life, we see it during menopause. Men, although they don't cycle physically like women do, they still go through the changes like women do. Hmm. It's called andropause instead of menopause.
Hmm.
And yes, it'll play a big role because there's like a tier. Underneath, I see the nutritional, you know, stability to give us the precursors to make our hormones, to give us a precursor to make our neurotransmitters.
Okay.
So we really want to make sure everything's in balance. It starts with good nutrition.
Right.
But if we are suffering from depression, one thing that I have noticed with my patients over the past 12 years is it's a very learned behavior. And although our neurotransmitters could be off and we could take nutraceuticals to balance that, we also have to realize that it takes a shift in consciousness. You know, we were talking earlier about how much mind over matter, you know, plays a role. And so I brought a demonstration of that. Like, for example, and I'll move this kit, the kit that measures the hormones. If I talk about us as being layers. So let's just say that this is the layer of, you know, feel-good hormones, and this is the layer of, you know, instability. Mm-hmm. It's pretty rocky. You know, we're going to be unbalanced all of the time, so everything could make us feel down. But if it was the other way around, and our feel-good hormones were higher and our toxicity was less, it's a lot more stable.
Mm-hmm.
There's two things, too much toxins and too little nutrients to build up, you know, what we need. So what I tell my patients is, what is that shift in consciousness or belief system, because mind over matter is extreme, is we want to adapt whether we're in the throes of depression or just kind of not having a good day, is basically living in gratitude. And that's learned, because we're not taught that.
Right.
And my patients say, I wish my mom taught me this. Unless I learned this in school. And so we really have to be conscious. And that's where journaling is a very important thing, is at least it gives you a minute to look at our behavior, our choices, and who we're surrounding ourselves with.
Yeah, it does start from that. I think sometimes as you get older and you get set in your ways, it's very hard to change that
It is
attitude.
Harder as you get older, absolutely.
But that's a good thing to teach our children, so I do like that. Thank you, Dr. Ramsey.
You're welcome.
It's good to see you. We're going to talk more about this, obviously, in the next couple of weeks with the holidays coming so close now. And if you'd like to contact Dr. Ramsey, of course, you can go to our website or dial our hotline. Thank you again. Coming up next.